For 75 years, from the beginning of Bishop Angelo Palazzi, we have chosen to serve God in any way that we can, to share the faith. So today we have a procession of 75 candles representing each year. We begin, Sister Lucy Low, Sister Lucy Chun, our vicaress, will be carrying up a picture of Bishop Palazzi, followed by our community and our friends. About 75 of us, so we need some extra help. So they're there with their smiling faces to represent a year each. So let us begin.
Thank you. confirm with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe that in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For one believes with the heart and so is justified, and one confesses with the mouth and so is saved. For the scripture says, no one who believes in him will be put to shame. For there is no distinction between Jews and Greeks. The same Lord is Lord of all, and reaching all who call upon him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. But how can they call on him in whom they have not believed?
Himself a Franciscan, received approval for our dear Franciscan sisters and our sorrowful mother to be established as, back then, a diocesan community. Such humble beginnings, close to home, eventually gave way to the missionary thrust of the gospel. The sisters became known as the Franciscan Missionary Sisters, and they expanded their ministries to four countries, one of which, fortunately for us, is our own. It was in June of 1953, at the request of our own Archbishop Edward Howard, that the sisters came here to staff St. Mary's Home for Boys. And then at their own initiative, that very same year, the sisters began the work of establishing Our Lady of Peace Retreat House, a true spiritual oasis, not only for Catholics, but for people of faith, whoever discovered that beautiful spot. Dear sisters, we, your friends and supporters, are here today to celebrate this Mass of Thanksgiving with you. Grateful, very grateful, in fact, for your witness of faith and your lives of service. And hopeful, very hopeful, that the Lord will continue to bless you and your missionary labors of love. Sisters, you truly are disciples of mission, as we're all called to be on the day of our baptism, but you really do it. Helping our Lord continue the work of proclaiming the good news and calling people to conversion. Now, not surprisingly, the readings chosen for today's Mass clearly reflect the missionary chasm of you good sisters. As we just heard St. Paul say, everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. But how can they call on him in whom they have
to consecrate myself more fully to him? I, sister, renew my vows of chastity, poverty, and obedience according to the rule of St. Francis and the constitution of the Franciscan Missionary Sisters, Our Lady of Sorrows, in the presence of our Archbishop.
By the authority entrusted to me by our ordinary Archbishop Alexander Sample, sisters, I accept the renewal of your vows in the name of the Church with the Franciscan Missionary Sisters of Our Lady of Sorrows. And I commend all of you earnestly to God that you may fulfill your dedication, which is united with this Eucharistic sacrament. Everyone, please respond, amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
in deep gratitude, praise, and glory to our God as we celebrate our 75th Jubilee, an anniversary of God's loving care and faithfulness.
Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from me, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Thank you. mystery of faith.
Power and glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Following. We were
planning on having like people sitting at certain tables, but there were so many people wanting to sit with that sister and this sister and that. I didn't have tables big enough for everybody. So what we're asking is that we're going to ask Father Carey to give our grace before meal here. And then as you come in, you have your little ticket there. Just go to the table you'd like to be, put it down, and then please enjoy your meal. We have a wonderful setup. Volunteers have come out of the walls to make this day special for all of us. So please, let's pray together, and then come and enjoy. We fed ourselves spiritually. Now I think we're all pretty hungry. Thank you.
This is my new pastor. I have named him. I hope he doesn't work out.
Let us pray. Loving and compassionate Lord, source of all blessing and goodness, we praise and thank you for this wonderful celebration of the 75th foundation of the sisters. You have always blessed us with your bounty and sustained us with your loving providence. We ask you to bless the food that we are about to partake in a few minutes, and bless those hands who made it possible for us from field to the table. We also lift up to you those who have nothing to partake today. And let us pray all together. Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts, which we are about to receive from thy bounty, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Again, thank you, sisters, for inviting us to your party. It's been a wonderful, wonderful celebration to be with you. It's been wonderful to serve this local church in your company this many years. Before Mass, I asked Vicki, did she have some special music for us today? She said, you bet I do. You did. Thank you very much to our music ministers. You did a wonderful job. Thank you to our servers. And thank all of you for coming, because Amory didn't want to force you to come in. At any rate, you know, I don't know if you noticed this or not. I deliberately mentioned saints whose feast we're celebrating today, even though this was not the number one topic on the prayer list. Saint Anne and Saint Joachim. Who is the major superior of the religious sisters? Is it a coincidence that we're celebrating? At any rate, happy feast day to you, your sister Anne Marie, please. May God bless you very, very much. And through you, may God bless you. So the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. there's just a lot of improvement.
I don't know what this is.
Where's the kingdom?